Alright guys, welcome back to the channel, and I'm just going to do a little something different. I'm going to do a little quick review on the phase. I'm going to tell you how I feel about it and how everything's going to, or what's happening around it. But let's jump right into it. Alright, so what you're going to do is, just like a Serato box, if you ever had to deal with one, you're going to have to connect channel A and B. So A goes to the left side and B goes to the right side. And with this one, since I have the S9, I don't know, I'm not sure how other mixers are, if they have the CD line with the phono line, but my turntables are connected to the phono line, and you connect the phase to the CD line and you just go to Serato and switch out the turntables to the CDJs, and then it will run that. Oh no, play. All right, before you put down your little Bluetooth controller, you put down a strip, a magnet strip that's like, has like a adhesive tape or adhesive on it right here, or wherever you want to put it, and then you just boom, it locks in the magnets that are behind here, and boom, that's all you gotta really do. That's all you really have to do with this. It's like very simple, but also it has its downsides where I'll talk about that later. But all in all, it does seem like a really good tool to have if you don't want to deal with your just casual needles, or even if you want to replace your needles and go do this all the time. Alright, so after playing around with the phase, doing a couple scratches, do a little bit of mixing here and there, I think this is just basically all my opinion and what I've heard about it and over since it's been released. I think the phase is a really good tool for us DJs that still run 1200s, and a good option to whenever your needles are messing up, or if you don't have any needles or have just don't want to buy anymore and just switch to digital, this is a really good thing to do without spending like $1,200 on a new Rain 1200 or even some CDJs. But you guys know that I run some Denons, and those are good too, but it's all in personal preference on what you want to take out, because I'm always taking out my Denons because it's always much more easier to carry and to use, and I don't have to worry about getting dust on my vinyl or on my needles, or and making sure that I'm moving it up each, like, 15 minutes, so I can keep that mix going and make sure nothing's gonna mess up and I don't have to deal with vibrations. But with the phase, you're basically doing what I just, not gonna do what I just said, or not dealing with dust on the needles or the vinyl, moving it up. But when, but it does switch to internal mode, but all I gotta do is switch it back. But that's like a one-time thing, and it's not gonna bother you for the rest of the night. And also, 10 hours of use to like a 2-hour charge, that's pretty good, in my opinion. You use that like for like, for me, like 3 gigs or so. But for club DJs, I'm pretty sure that works out for them too. On the downside, people are having problems with the phase with connection, and I believe, and I think connecting it to your computer. But I have it connected to a power source to use it, so maybe try switching the power source to just not connecting it to your computer, to just a regular outlet. But it works fine with me. But I'll do a second updated review once mine comes in, and whenever I put it out to test, whenever I take it to gigs, to Don Vino's, to see how it really sets up. And yeah, to just test. Once I get mine, I'm gonna take mine out, do a second review on the road, just like me whenever I do events, and put it to the test, see how good it really is. Because it would be nice to not carry needles everywhere and then have to worry about buying replacements. But also, to those DJs that are taking off their tone arm on their 1200, don't do it, because this thing is still brand new. And I would say wait for like a big update or something till they fix all those issues that everyone is having, because that's what everyone is basically dealing with, connection issues. And that's all it is. All you have to do is just basically wait until Phase brings out a really big update, and then these bad boys will start being a little more better. And it's like GTA 5, and once, because that game was very highly anticipated, and everyone, once the online just turned on, everyone started to go in at once, and it flooded the servers and made, like, it took, like, well, almost over a month so it could, so they could, like, fix it, be, and have more, you know, make it run smooth. So I think we should all give, you know, FaZe a good amount of time to, so they could work these connection issues, because the Phase was pushed back several weeks beforehand once it was first was supposed to release. So I think we should all give them time to work on a huge patch, or so they could make sure once you're going to use it, it's going to be reliable throughout each and every game throughout the whole year, or how long it's going to last. But for now, it's a really good concept. I like it. Once I get mine, I'm going to use it, do a second review on doing it on the road. But I advise all DJs to make sure to have a backup of, like, have your needles with you, and don't get rid of your tone arm because the Phase came out. If you can get rid of your tone arm, buy a 1200, rain 1200, but, well, whatever. But just make sure you guys have your back whenever this decides to not connect right. But anyways, let me know what you guys want to see more of on the channel, and let me know down in the comments on your thoughts on Phase. And don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, help grow the channel, do what you gotta do, and see you guys next time.